to whom it may concern. Let me tell you a story. As a matter of fact, a true story. Not to glorify the life he lived, but to know how he lived. And no one has ever heard or remembers him. You will hear the same cities. New York, New Jersey, Philly, Atlanta, and even Durham, North Carolina. You will hear his contemporaries, Nicky Barnes, Frank Lucas, Melvin Combs, Frank Matthews, and even the mob. After I finish this story, you will wonder why and how you never heard of Earl Fadrell, the forgotten American guest.
Never knew this about me. No one never knew this about my life. Unless somebody told them, Dwight. Nobody. I never said nothing about this.
I hadn't seen him in a while. Little did I know he was on the run then. So everybody else knew what was going on, but I didn't. My daddy, I don't even call him by his name.
Nobody messed with me at all. I paid them every month, and I had a free run. The morning that they come there, to arrest me. The phone call came and told me they was on their way. They knocked the door down at 5 o'clock in the morning. I mean, with sledgehammers and everything. Came in like gangbusters. All men police, so when they came through the house, with the shirts wanting everything. They got ready to go to my bedroom. And my wife was in the bedroom. That's when I told my, ain't no man going in that bedroom. If you do, you might as well shoot me now because you're not gonna disrespect my wife like that. So they sent downstairs and got a female police and had her to come up and handcuff my wife, and which was Gloria. They took us both to jail. They gave her $100,000 bail and gave me one for $350,000. I made bail within 2 days. Then after I made bail, I went made her bail and got her out. And she was shaking like a leaf on a tree. Never been arrested a day in her life, never knew what it is. And I mean, when I tell you arrested for nothing, the connect called the house one night and she said, my husband told me to tell you he'll see you the same time next week. And that's what the end of the conversation for her and the connect was there. They took that conversation because they had my phone tapped. They took that conversation and said that she was using the telephone illegally. And she ended up doing a year in jail for bullshit. But anyway, she ended up getting out after a year. I went away for 5 years. While I was away, I made sure that she was taking care of me and everything. Money was never no real problem with me. I always had plenty of money. Anyway, while I was in jail, she came to visit. For the whole 5 years, I was incarcerated in a jail called Lewisburg Federal Penitentiary in Lewisburg, Pennsylvania. That's where I met this son of a bitch, Henry Hill. and a guy named Paul Massey. And we hooked up in jail. And I did my time and came home. But I met a few connecting there. I met a guy named Rafael Santana, which was a coke man, one of the biggest coke dealers on the Eastern Seaboard.
I was 18 when all of this happened. No, I was 19 when they took him away. Mm-hmm. I ain't never know he was a drug dealer. I thought he owned restaurants and sold and did income taxes. He was smooth, right?